we do not carry. Be distracted by distractions.
Yes.
And press on toward the walk of Jesus Christ. God's got a way of meeting you at the point of your needs. He'll make the enemy sit down and shut up. Hallelujah. He'll cause the host of heaven to come together and help you to celebrate. Hallelujah. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. And the tongue that rises against me in judgment shall be condemned. I'm glad tonight I serve a God who will speak up for me. Look at your neighbor and tell him, you got to fight all your battles. To hold your peace and let God fight your battle. Tell him you serve a God that will speak up for you. And you can't even defend yourself. Sometimes you don't know what to say. Oh, I serve a God who will speak up for you. Don't let the master catch you sleeping. Of assignment is broken focus on distraction.
Yes.
The enemy has caused all of us, for some reason or another, to become uncharacteristically interested in the affairs of other people.
Yes.
Sometimes the things that we are interested in have nothing to contribute to what God is trying to do in us.
Yes.
In other words, I'm just saying that the spirit of busybody or the spirit of nosy has afflicted the body of Christ, and we are so concerned about what others are doing that we have allowed our own assignments to go dormant and unaddressed.
Yeah.
But let me tell you, you can plan and you can organize and you can coordinate and even decorate, but I promise you, you will always find yourself at a disappointing crossroad. It is not until you take heed to the word that says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and all of his righteousness. Some of us are chasing jobs and positions, and we're chasing relationships, and we're chasing recognition and celebration. But can I tell you, you will always find yourself at a disappointing crossroad until you say yes unto God. And you must know that if he told us that he was coming back on July the 7th, 2012, most of us would have lived a life full of sin until midnight tonight. And wouldn't that be a prayer meeting in every church across America? Don't you know if God told us that I'll be back on August the 4th, 2013, what a party some of you would have if you could pinpoint and tie down the morning that I will, that which God is coming. And it is similar or parallel into our own lives, because God will lead us to a degree where we are full of answers, but then we are ushered into a dimension where now we have more questions than answers. And so Pastor McCart has spoiled me with answers, but then he delivers me to a season where I can't get one prayer answered. What do I do with thee? When you have been in a place where God has answered all of your prayers, you ask Elijah about that. When you've been in a place where every time you spoke to God, he spoke right back. You said hi, and he said hey. You said hello, he said how you doing? But now you're in a place where you cannot sin to get a prayer through. Is there anybody who will sanctify yourself? Ever been to a place where the more you pray, it seems like the less you know him? What do I do when I cannot hear the Lord? What you do is right there in verse 33. When you cannot hear God for your new prayer, then you must take heed to what you've already heard. But we want God to say something new. But why would God say something new to us when we have not mastered what he has already said? Whether you know it or not, there are many of us in this room that have not mastered doctrine. We have not mastered obedience. We have not mastered submission. We have not mastered giving. We have not mastered love. Y'all don't hear me preach, I'm preaching anyway. We've not mastered humility. We've not mastered forgiveness and repentance. And so why would God speak something new to me only to compound upon that I have left undone? Tell your neighbor, you've got some work to do. Most of us have the problem is what we compare ourselves to each other. And see, sometimes you don't know what you're doing is you're comparing yourself to a hypocrite. And when you start comparing yourself to a hypocrite, the only thing it. This is a hypocrite. No, look at your neighbor and tell him you might go to hell watching me. Don't nobody want to talk to nobody. I said, look at your neighbor and tell him you might go to hell watching me. No, the Bible said that you have to work out your soul salvation with fear and trembling. If we would get our eyes off of each other, no, and I hear the Apostle Paul saying, I'm impressed. No, I'm not pressing toward a person, no, but I'm pressing toward the monk. No, and I know where to find the monk because the monk is in his word. No, why is it that we will examine the flesh, no, but we will not examine the spirit? No, you're going to have to take an examination of yourself. No, why would I examine myself? Well, you need to examine yourself because I found out, no, that demonic spirits know how to hide behind gifts. No, you can be gifted in an area, no, but sometimes your gift, no, is only a small screen, no, to hide your demons. No. Now, some of us, no, are in a state of denial. No. There, but you think that I can lie that it's not there, and then maybe it'll go away, maybe it ain't going nowhere. No, demons have to be addressed and confronted. No, they have to be called out and then cast out. Y'all want to talk into me? No, I'm just glad that, but the Bible tells me right here, no, he says no man knows that day. No, so I don't care who gets deep in spiritual, because God is not going to contradict himself, no, to make a wonder out of one individual. No, if the Bible says nobody knows, no, then tell your neighbor, nobody knows.
Nobody knows.
Then he says here, watch and take heed. No, and then when you get to watching that, no, then he also says pray. No, see, because when you watch, no, and you do not pray, no, you get disturbed by what you see. No, and you'll come up with a revelation, no, that is not from God. That's why when you watch it, God can't be you. No. See, some of you are not prayerful enough, no, to substantiate the nosiness that's in you. No. See, because you got to be prayerful, no, to know what you think you know about me. No. And not come up with the wrong resolution. No. See, the reason that people have miscalculated you, no, because they were watching you, but they were not praying. No. So you saw something that you did not understand, no, but you didn't have the Holy Ghost to see what God was working out of me. But tell your neighbor, I know I'm a mess, but God is working me through. Every time prayer goes on, you want to be running to the house of God. How can you be effective in your ministry and you do not have a prayer life? How can you be a minister? How can you be an elder? And how can you be a prophet? How can you be a missionary? You cannot make it to brother, pastor. Get off of work in time. But you never ask for a key to come in the late night hour. So you've been using your work schedule as an excuse not to pray. That's the reason that your ministry is weak. That's the reason that there is no anointing in your statue. Because some things only come through prayer. He says, if y'all don't have to hit me, but I tell you the truth. If not people who are called by my name, sometimes. No, if you believe in the power of prayer, no, then I can't afford to wait until I get in trouble, no, to talk to God. No, because now that all of my prayer, no, is consumed with this bill and this sickness and this disease. No, you have to spend some time with God, no, talking to him about priorities of the kingdom. No, God, I don't need a bill paid, but I do need some anointing. No, I do need a revelation. No, I do need foresight and insight. No, I've been making decisions. And at this time, I need you to open up my eyes and help me to see what it is you're saying to the church. See, it's one thing to be gifted to preach, but it's something else when you have an anointing to preach. Because when you're anointed men of God, chains will become loose, shackles will be shattered, people's minds will be changed. I don't want anybody to enjoy me. I just want you to be shifted. You don't ever to like my preaching, but I want you to be shifted by it, because it's the anointing below that destroys every yoke. But the Bible that I read says, woe unto those been singing the solo for so long. It's a comfortable place because I know I can do that out of gift. The challenge is if I step out this, I know even when I ain't feeling God, I ain't got my gift to rest on. I told the preacher the other day, I said, the problem in the church is that we're garnering fans and not followers.
All right.
It's a danger when you got a church full of fans. Because fans will jump for you. When you're up, they'll jump on you. When you mess up, don't let him come and fight.
Hallelujah.
We get what God
done.
Don't be a loud person and a silent evangelist.
Every day.
You want to tell
somebody
that Jesus saved.
Every day.
You want to let somebody know that he's the answer. You ought to live so
Hallelujah.
God can use you anytime.